about 12% of people appear to have an enzyme deficit that impairs the conversion of the short chain omega-3 fatty acids from flax oil to the long chain omega-3 fatty acids that are needed. So I cannot uniformly give advice to vegan women that all of them are going to be able to support their necessary EPA and DHA levels by taking flaxseed. It's also difficult because there's a high burden of the omega-6 fatty acids competing. If you work really hard, you can get some end-arounds. You can take algae-produced DHA to support your levels. I think it's very important that people who are committed vegans, they get their blood levels checked. There's many different companies that offer blood spot levels, Ideal Omega Test, Metametrics, Great Smoky Labs, and many others. As a U.S. government employee, I'm not going to endorse one over the other. But the important thing is to actually get the blood level and not guess as what you've achieved. There's an algae-derived DHA on the market from Martech that was originally developed for the use of infant formula because mammalian breast milk is very rich in DHA. And it's a very fine source of DHA and a very good source for vegetarians.
But it's only DHA, no EPA.
It's only DHA. If you work on nixing the sixes and freeing up the enzymes, you can potentially get conversion from taking flax oil to make the EPA and then take the DHA on top of it. It's hard to do. If you take that approach, I encourage getting your blood level checked to make sure you've actually done it. I look for the supplements that most closely resemble fish. I think the safest course is get supplements with both, EPA and DHA. I think you do best with both.